Hi everybody, I'm John Koepke, a ranger at Government Cayon State Natural Area here in San Antonio. We're standing in our dinosaur tracks. These are dinosaur tracks that date from over 100 million years ago. That's really a long, long time ago. That's even older than me. So these tracks, why are they here? You know, they're here because, believe it or not, at one time, hundreds of millions of years ago, this part of San Antonio was actually a shoreline, you know, like a beach. But unlike a beach that we think of as being soft, sandy, pretty, the beaches at that time, which was during the Cretaceous period, were more like, they were more like a sidewalk, kind of limey, full of sediment, mud, clay. And just like a sidewalk, when they're allowed to dry in the sun, if an animal walks across them, they leave their footprints in that material. And then if those footprints are never disturbed and allowed to dry, just like in a sidewalk, it hardens into stone. So what we have here is the remnants of a beach where dinosaurs walked across it, and it was just the right consistency for them to press down into it and create footprints, which then dried in the sun and hardened into stone. And that's why we still have them here today. So here we have one of our theropod tracks. Remember, theropod means 2 feet, 3 toes, eats meat. This particular track is very well defined because we can not only see each of the 3 toes, but if you look very closely, you can see the pointed area of the heel, as well as the individual talon marks, which would have been the claws at the end of each of the toes. This particular track is sunk very deep. It actually extends, this toe print extends well under the rock, as it does over here as well. I'll just clean this out a little bit, and you can get a better idea of the individual shapes of the toes. This particular animal, we believe to have been about 11 feet tall at the hip. Now, how tall is 11 feet? Have you ever seen a basketball game? If you have, you know that the rim of the basket is at 10 feet. Now go up 1 foot from there, which would be to the top of the little red box that they usually have behind the rim, and that's where the hip of the animal was. Pretty big animal. We can tell from the series of tracks that we have the left foot, the right foot, the left foot, the right foot of this one particular individual, and from that distance between the stride, we can estimate that this animal was moving at about 2 miles an hour. Now, what's interesting about that is, how fast do you think an average human being walks? Well, the answer is typically 2 miles an hour. Who knew we could go as fast or as slow as the dinosaurs? I'm standing now at the sauropod trackway here at Government Cayon State Natural Area. The sauropod trackway is located very close to where the theropod tracks are as well, but they were not put down at the same time. These tracks are considered to be younger than the theropod tracks because they are up higher. They're at a higher elevation, which means that as the beach was laying down sediment, it would have been building up over time so that when it was this low, the theropods would have walked along the beach and left their tracks. But then when it was up here, the sauropods would have walked across and left their tracks. As a reminder, the sauropod tracks represent an animal that had 4 legs with round feet and 8 plants. This particular trackway shows 19 tracks from a single animal. Now, believe it or not, because the tracks are relatively small for the type of animal that it was, we believe that this was a juvenile sauropod, which means like a teenager. So the adults would have been much, much bigger. People often ask, what is the largest dinosaur track out at Government Cayon State Natural Area? Well, this is it. This is one of the tracks of the sauropod. This would have been a rear foot. The rear feet would have been much bigger than the front feet. As you look at this track, it's really well defined. And by that I mean, it clearly shows the imprint of the animal as it was walking this way along the beach. Here would be the front or the toes, and back here would be the heel. And we see that the toes actually sunk deeper than the heel, which is similar for the way we walk. Another clue is we look for what's known as an impact crater. An impact crater is what happens whenever you or any animal steps into something that's squishy and it kind of squeezes up around where the print was made. So if we look at this, we see all the way around it, it's kind of mounded up. And that's because it is mounded up. When the animal stepped into this, it squeezed some of that material out and formed a rim around the impact crater. It's one of the ways that helps us identify where tracks are and where they're not, because sometimes it can be difficult to tell the difference. People often ask us, when did we first discover the tracks? Well, the fact of the matter is, we didn't first discover the tracks. These tracks have been here for over 1 million years, actually over 100 million years. So this area has been occupied by human beings for a very, very long time. Tens of thousands of years, actually, with Native Americans and other indigenous cultures. It's fair to say that they would have seen these tracks as well, but may not have known what they were. To be perfectly honest, when we first saw them way back in the 90s, was when we were first looking at this property, we recognized them as potentially dinosaur tracks, but we weren't really sure because none of us were scientists. None of us were paleontologists. It took many years before we were able to partner with a local museum, the Woody Museum, and through the help of their scientists and paleontologists, as well as other area professors and geologists, hydrogeologists, paleontologists, biologists, we were able to identify that these are in fact dinosaur tracks. That information comes to us through their years of experience working on these sorts of things around the world. As a matter of fact, the paleontologist for the Woody Museum, Dr. Thomas Adams, is well known as an expert in dinosaur tracks throughout the world. We're fortunate to be able to be partnered with them. So that's how we know that they are tracks. That's how we know what we know about them. But for many years, none of us knew anything more than, yeah, we have these imprints that look to us like dinosaur tracks, and maybe they are and maybe they aren't. It's good to know that they are, though, because that way they're a lot more fun. So now I'm standing at one of my favorite places at Government Cayon State Natural Area. We call this the Overlook. We're standing on a cliff directly above the dinosaur tracks. But what I like about it is from here, you can look and see, I like to think, into the future. What you've seen so far today has to deal with the past. But as we stand here, we can think about the future. What will we do? Where will we go? Well, we hope you come to Government Cayon State Natural Area and do some exploring of your own out here. There's a world to discover. Okay, so that wraps it up for today, kids. Thanks for coming out to join us. If you'd like to learn more, please visit TPWDiscover or go to the link you see below. Adios.